Hi guys, today I'll be showing you how to make these zombie killing bats. So I will be giving you some useful tips and crazy options. So without wasting any time, let's start. So let's start with the bat. I'm going to the front view and I'm selecting a curve. I'm drawing a one side of its pattern. Okay, I'm doing it a little roughly. Now I'm gonna fix this like this. This is gonna be here. This is gonna be here. So because I'm doing this in curve, we can get the lots of control if you make from curves. I know it should be, you gonna say that it is gonna be easy with polygon faces, but I'm showing a new another way to make these things. I can model also in polygon obviously, but I just wanna show you this technique so that may be useful for you. It's really helpful when you're gonna make wine glass or a bottle. I really like when you're gonna model this. Okay, so when you got a basic shape, go to the curve and surface and revolve. So you wanna this, okay? The reason why I made this in curve, because the curve is still there, okay? If you going to adjust this, it will be gonna move easily. You can adjust this. So it is another cool way to model. I'm watching references. As I told everyone, reference is the most important part. My team lead always read me that if you collect your reference properly, then you have done the modeling part. I mean your task almost 50%. So I do take him seriously. Okay, it seems fine. Just comparing with this. Sorry. And I'm using a Irfan view, and I'm not promoting anything, but it helps because it can stay on the always on top option, so you can check with your monitor. Okay, this feels okay to me. Now what you have to do, just select this mesh and go to modify, convert. It's gonna be nodes to polygon, but we need to go to the box quad. No, it's gonna be control point. It should look like this, okay? And I can now rid of these things. Okay, so I have the I hided the wrong thing. Okay, this is the model, this is the polygon. So I'm going to smooth ones. part. Now we're gonna make the wires. Yeah, so I just give a basic material to it. Now let's make the curve. I mean the wire. Go to create polygon. Cylinder. Make it 6. Cap 0. Height should be radius low. Option layer a bit unused. Okay. Height is pretty much little bit high. You can take this much. 20 is fine. And the height should be 10. Radius is low. And the reason why I said low because I don't know actually how much should be work. Every time I did I add some loop and check it again. I think this is too much gap. You should need little more. 30. Yeah, let's say 30. Delete this. Now duplicate it. Move a little. It should be look like this. Okay. Intersect it a little bit. So that when you merge the vertexes, it won't merge together. Okay, combine it. Center pivot. Snap to grid. Now go to deform. Now linear. Twist. Now add this. It should be multiplication of 360. I mean 360 into 3. 1080. The reason it should be multiplication of 360 because it will end the straight on the straight. Okay, for that's why. Then plus 360 because its gap is too much. I don't need that much gap. 1440. It's still much. I will be adding this until I will see a good amount of loops like this. I think one more should be enough. 2160. Okay, I like this. Okay, remove it means clean the history. Sorry, not remove it. Go to polygon. Create polygon helix. You will add in how much height. Coil should be 3 is enough. 2 point something is fine. Width don't need so much. Coil 10 will be more than enough. And the distance should be the same as this thickness, so I'm going to reduce it height so that I'm going to duplicate it so that this the tightness of and for this tightness, and it has the four pins, four angles. So if I am gonna coil it like this, it still have two points, not four. So what I'm going to do, I'm doing this, and extrude, select those faces and extrude, go like this. And if you turn it, yeah, you have to just eyeball it, no problem at all. This is a small pin, this is fine, I guess. And extrude it, select this point, extrude it inwards. Okay, join this. You should not do any errors on meshes. Yeah, and then simply duplicate it and rotate it like this. It gonna have that four pin feeling to it. Okay, and the problem is now that it is too thick. I don't need that much thick. Select all the vertex, shift right click, transform component, and doing it, shrinking it little bit. And guys, if you liking this video, it is fine, the scaling down is working. Guys, if you like this video, then please support me so that I can bring you more tutorials. If you motivate me, then I will be definitely doing much for you. The reason, because I am lifting this and this rather than this. It gonna round, so I want to make sure that this distance is equal to this and this distance equal to this distance. So I'm just eyeballing it. This should be fine, no issues. Little rough will be add some naturality to it. Okay, so this is our pen. Please guys, to subscribe so that I can get you more videos. Okay, it's done. Where is my bat? Now the rings are only in this parts, so I'm gonna duplicate it. And if you need to ask anything, you can ask me. I have a mail ID on my channel description. I will be make sure that I will be get back to you. Now add some random loops like this. I'm adding little less because it's just easy to duplicate. That will be help more. Just select one ledge. Your model is ready right there, and it is the placing system. So select this edge, go to modify, convert, edit polygon edges to curve. Okay, you have to do all the curves one by one, because it won't work all at the same time. I'm working on it. If I'm able to make a script for it, then I will be definitely adding this to this description. And also you can press G to repeat your actions. Okay, now I'm heading this. I don't need this. Now select all the rings. Go to surface, revealed, sorry, curve revealed, not surface revealed. 8 should be fine. You can add 10 for this object. Why I'm doing this? Because if you can see, wait, I can, if I am able to find anything. Did I just convert it? Yeah, I did convert it. So the rings is generated like this. Okay, if you add those paths to it, then it will be messed up around it, so it's necessary to make a rebuild on it. Okay, so when you find this rebuild, it's gone. Okay, now what you need to do, turn on your, not this one, delete, yeah, baseball bat. I am scaling it little bit. I don't need it that much thick, and place it on the middle of the point. Try, because I'm going to use curve wrap option, and it sometimes it got messed up. Reset, sorry, not reset, yes, reset, no, not reset, modify, freeze transform, center pivot. Okay, so how am I going to do this? Duplicate it once, and I have to make this side. So select this and this, and go to deform curve wrap. I already remove it to myself, so you can just click it. Okay, it should be like this. Okay, it seems good to me. I will be telling you this, how you can merge this. Let me, you don't need to add the similar ones. You can just duplicate it over it. That will be more easier. Okay, you have to add in the unique one. Okay, so I'm duplicating this, adding this to curve wrap. Okay, it should be like this. Go to the curve wrap, and it's always has to, the length size is 2. That will be better. Okay, and duplicate again. To this one. Because you are using curve wrap and not rotating the model like something this, or just stretching around it, so that's the benefit. You won't get messed up. Like if you want to if you manually place these things and trying to select this and soft selection this and this, moving around and shaping it across, then what will really happen, then the consistency of this object is gonna messed up. once it somewhere it gonna go squish, somewhere it should be okay, I will show you this. If you moving like this and this, then this is going to stretch. Okay, this is not good. This is totally not good. I don't like it. It's removing its consistency. It's all about its consistency. Okay. So that's why I'm doing this. Otherwise, I can just model a ring, then I can duplicate all the things. But topic is not about the ring. Okay. You can use it many ways. Like if you think that you have a frog, okay, and you need to make his belt or the ribbon under it, you have to just make a straight and assign it to, wait, I will be showing you a little bit. Sorry, I have this dinosaur. I will be showing you later. No issues. I have references. Sorry, I didn't. I'm checking this, but I don't have right now. So again, select this one model and curve wrap. Okay. Select this curve wrap. Okay. And the rest of this I'm going to duplicate, no issues. Okay, so now what you have to do, just separate it like this. Now select all the vertices, control right click, go to selection boundary. Okay, it will select all the loops for you. Then just go to merge vertices, and you can adjust the threshold. Should be no? 2 is too much. 1.5 too much. 1.2 still too much. So yeah, it's fine. I will merge it together like this. That will be little easier. So merging this, I'm merging it, and I will be back to you soon. Okay, wait, I will show you something. If you need to merge a open vertices, okay, control right click, then select all the vertices first, and control right click, then select boundary. Okay, what will we do? It select the open faces where it is open. So if you going to merge it, then it will affect only these things. Rather than people what did, just select all the vertices, go to merge vertices, get merge vertices. So then the other things also get merged. Okay, well, it should not get affected. So this is my trick. So all select all the vertices, control right click, go to boundary, and it will be select if there is any open faces. Like if I delete this selection, select boundary, it will select this face. Okay, so So now be done with it. Now what I do, just select these things, clean the history, center pivot, select one of them, duplicate, go to the this thing. Okay, have the pivot over here and rotate it like this. Okay, I'm not soft selectioning anything, okay, because that's, I don't like that. That loses the information of your model. That is bad. Okay, and you can also do some random, these loops also not perfect. I mean, not exact the thing that you might need your wire should be. Okay, you can delete these things. One more tip, you can turn off this polygon option and you can select all the curves without selecting the polygon. If you turn on the wire, turn off the wire, then you have selecting all the polygons, not the curves. So rather than doing one by one, I can do this. Okay, problem is the every three sided on the same place, actually the rings almost on the same place, so we need to rotate it like this. Before that, select all the models, go to the top view, D, X, center, snap the middle button to the grid point. This channel is only for the tips. I am not telling you how to model things, okay, like other channels and like one by one options. As this option is here, this option is there, like if you need to select convert this selection to vertices, then you have to shift control right click to vertices to vertices. I am not telling this, okay, I know you know this. I don't want to waste your time, okay, I want that. That's why it's called 3D tips, so that you could do faster, right? So guys, please do support me, subscribe to my channel. It will be helpful. I'm sick, I'm really sick. I'm duplicating this, turning this. Okay, now I'm going to turn my bat. This is like this. Okay, I can just scale it because the pivot is on the center. Everyone's, I can scale like this. Okay, and some more detail I want to add on it, on the bat. So this face, select this face, duplicate, combine, select all face, extrude like this, select this, scale down. Okay, I'm absolutely on this, beveling this. I will be make on a video on bevel and grease. Please tell me in the comment box that it should be helpful or not, because I'm going to tell the usefulness, the crease and the bevel for ZBrush, which should be better. You can do something good. Yeah, if you like to hear about it, then I should do. Okay, please tell me. Okay, so this is how our bats looks like with the wired. Okay, I think it's cool, it's looking good. I can duplicate couple of times, it will be good to see. I think it's pretty close to this. What do you think? Please let me know in the comment box. I think it looks good. And if you think that I'm doing it so fast, then please tell me. I'm going to be a little bit slower. At least I will try, because I'm working on a production, so I really used to do fast things. So, and I'm really in love with Maya, and this is my first 3D software which I learned. So by the way guys, I'm working in this industry almost for 5 years, and I'm still working on some company. I work some big games, work in some big games really, but it's not allowed to tell in public, so it's fine. I'm sad. Okay, so this is it. I think it looks great. What do you think? Let me know in the comment box. I like this really, and you may add some nails over here, pins over here, that will be looks amazing. And some straps for this, like something this, because if you're gonna fight the zombie, and then you need to have a grip, right? So this is how you do a zombie bat.